have a favorite episode that you
did? I put a lot of love into the finales. I would say I love both 312 and 324, those finales. 312, the one where Scott becomes a true elf and his eyes change, and that episode was so hard to shoot. We were doing three units at a time, trying to make it amazing. 324 because I loved the fruition of all the coming together of this Void style storyline and facing the No Gibson A. And, I love those episodes. But there are a couple, it's hard to pick. I also love 501 because of the moment that Scott writes Allison's initials in the library. It's hard to kill a character off, but then you get to do moments like that, which are extremely meaningful. So it's funny, people ask me, would you go back and kill Allison, do Allison's death the same way? I don't know, but then I wouldn't have gotten that scene if we hadn't. And I really like that scene. And it's also a way of showing how teenagers can deal with death and not just be sad about it, but memorialize a friend who meant something to them. So I can't say I have a favorite. Yes.
Of all the characters, mainly the main characters over the years, which character has more of your qualities, your personal qualities that you kind of put into this character?
You know, it's funny. Styles has a lot of my sense of humor. I write Styles' voice. People would tell me they hear my voice in Styles. Mm-hmm. But Peter has a lot of my cynicism. I would say he's very close to my voice as well. Scott is the kind of person I wish I could be. So.
How do you write the parents on the show? Like, one of the things I love most about Teen Wolf is that the teens actually have parents that are involved in their lives.
Yeah.
So.
That was a big question, actually, when we first started the show, because we were trying to negotiate cast salaries. And the network asked me, well, how much are the parents really going to be in the show? Should we just put them for, like, three episodes? And I said, no, they're going to be important. They have to be important. Because it went back to, remember the first Nightmare on Elm Street, where the dad's just a bumbling idiot, and he's like, they're useless.
Yeah.
I didn't want useless parents.
Yeah.
I wanted them to be more like the adults in Harry Potter, or allies. That's how I wrote them, as allies. And I kind of based them on, like, Melissa's completely based on my own mother, even down to words that are similar to what she's spoken to me. Linsky was just a fun way of exploring this father-son relationship. Lyndon was just as important in creating that character as I was in writing his dialogue.